building, the section of building that we're going to add on is about 130,000 square feet.
So in terms of acres, are we looking at 20 acres, 10 acres?
Well, there's 42,360 square feet in acres. So a new building, you got 3 acres, give or take, a couple of feet, in terms of new building.
Okay, Gary? Close enough?
Yeah, thank you, good news.
The 100% extension and the parking, additional parking required, the parking seems to be the portion that extends into the, more into the wetland. Have you considered multi-tier parking? To eliminate the sprawl?
See, we haven't, through you, Mr. Chair, we haven't considered multi-tier parking specific to the fact that the cost of that is incredible. On-site parking, for example, a parking stall is roughly between $10,000 to $12,000. If you talk about a parking stall in a multi-tiered facility, it's between $30,000 and $35,000. So it puts everything way out of whack. Also, there's safety issues, sub-ted issues with regards to parking garages. So the on-site at-grade parking is preferred, certainly from a retail point of view and from a tourist's perspective. The total acreage that would be used that is not part of the significant, that chunk that sits there is 2 acres out of that. That's all that we'd be chewing up to make ensure that we have the parking that we require for the actual retail operation. So it's not a huge, significant part, considering Taurus owns another 80 acres of that wetland that will never ever be able to be utilized.
Okay.
I second the submission to the town of Innisfil and provided all that information for you. We received a letter in December from the town of Innisfil that was addressed to them from the NVCA saying that they would not support, based on the fact of the information that they had to date, and there were requests for all of this information. It was strategically, we met with the NVCA a number of times regarding the modeling and the area and how big this watershed was and what we were responsible for, and that model, we provided two hazardous reports. Subsequent to the requirements for the NVCA, we felt that all of these other issues with regards to soils, parking, wetland, could easily be addressed. Okay, once we had approval to move forward through the application.
You said, mentioned that you thought that the infilling issues could be quite easily addressed, but I haven't seen anything that indicates how or why you think that, or how those issues could be addressed. Do you have any ideas that you could share with us?
Go ahead.
For the chair. Yeah. For instance, just by the sheer fact of opening up a culvert under Highway 400, we will be reducing storage on the east side of Highway 400, perhaps by hundreds of thousands of cubic meters. There will never be a discussion of whether that's a good thing or not to open that culvert. Certainly it should be done safely and downstream to make sure we're not impacting people in terms of velocities and those kinds of things with that. But the fact is Highway 400 is providing a monstrous amount of floodplain storage upstream. As part of that, we would be nibbling away at a very small portion of that. And we feel that in combination with some type of, we would show, I guess, through a hydrologic modeling exercise, which I think would clearly show insignificance in the grand scheme of the watershed of this piece of floodplain storage. That doesn't address the cumulative effect that was referenced, but part of the cumulative effect also includes opening these culverts, which reduces floodplain storage by massive amounts. So it's not an easy answer.
But how would, practically, as we look at this process as we go forward, how would those, that potential for opening new culverts or expanding culverts come into play? Because that seems like an idea that could be possible at some point in the future right now, but in terms of this project going ahead, I mean, that's a seems to me quite a big hypothetical at this point.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. We have been approached, Taurus Management Group and MMM, through the town of Venisville to make representation to the MTO while this RFP is out. Okay, all the final designs have not been done at all. Basically, this is a request for proposal from engineering firms to do this work, okay? And it just came out in July. We were made aware of the report a week ago Wednesday, and that's why I sent it in as an exhibit. I think there's a huge opportunity at this point to work with the NVCA and the town of Venisville in cooperation to ensure that we have the right size for oversized capacity, the right kind of flows for new culverts that is going to alleviate huge issues with regards to stormwater and stormwater management on site.
This decision-making process, I don't think as an NVCA board member that we're happy about these outstanding reports and that, you know, you want to move forward without these reports being done. Several loops here. Culverts going north, I understand just currently they're under construction by the MTO. They were undersized, they are collapsing currently, and there's a process underway right now to sort of cement the inside of the culvert and making it smoother, making it smaller, which is not good. It's not good at all. The flow will increase because there won't be the ripple effect going through the culverts. So we do have some problems with the MTO and how we're going to get this done. But one of my concerns is with the existing floodplain, if this goes to the M&R, will they designate this area as provincially significant wetland? That's one concern I have, if it goes that far. I've got a few notes, so just bear with me there. I think we need to do is have a meeting somehow in the near future, which I think is proposed for this coming Tuesday, where we'll bring all the parties together, and I think that Don Eastwood, our Director of Infrastructure, can verify that. We are going to be working with another developer that will be bringing the pipe through that area, the water pipe, and they also understand the concerns with the flooding in this area. This area from 89 North is known as our economic district for Innisfil that we're looking to get approved. If this flooding problem is not solved now, it will come back to us year after year after year to the NVCA with flooding issues, so we really need to get this rectified now. The MTO is currently doing larger culverts to the south at 88 to accommodate what's happening in that area. We need to put pressure on them. The M&R, in my book, tend to be making policy when I don't think it's their job to make policy of what size of culvert to be put in there. They were undersized in the very beginning. So with our meeting on Tuesday and the other developer coming to the table to put pressure, and the county as well will put pressure on the MTO to rectify this problem. My concern is, though, there was a comment made earlier by staff that if the north, the Innisfil Creek culvert, and that flooding is rectified, will you delay the project, this Cookstown Outlet project, because of the flooding in the south tributaries? I don't want it going back and forth, back and forth. I think this has to be rectified by staff. So my question there to staff is, if the culverts to the north, the three are repaired or replaced, two sides, to reduce flooding for the future for all of our economic district, but the three to the south aren't, will you come back and delay this project for that area?
Great. Glenn, can anybody answer that question? Focusing on the Innisfil culverts, but
Through you, Mr. Chair, I've already committed to Mr. Eastwood that we will be there.
Okay. So that is an applicant or a board staff. Where it is satisfied that an adjournment is necessary for an adequate hearing to be held. Any adjournment shall form part of the hearing record. Okay. Clear? We have a motion or a point of order.
I'd like to put the motion.
This is even on a point of order right now. Okay. Are we done with your point of order?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I haven't finished reading the the motion was seconded by Mary Brett. If I didn't mention that before, I apologize. Okay, speaking on the motion, I'll let the mover speak first and then I'll move to each of the motions.
I think that we need to move forward with this meeting on Tuesday to paragraph we do this before we really decide to let them move forward or for defer this at this time. I don't think that's something we need to do right now. I think we have, we want to do a fairly quick turnaround on this and bring it back to the board fairly quickly, and hopefully this meeting on Tuesday can accomplish that. And I think we really need to make the MTO aware that this is, if they're working with the province and creating jobs and creating a place to live, work, and play, they need to cooperate in this direction as well.
Okay, before I get to Alicia, I'm going to let the proponent. You have an opportunity as well to speak on this motion, just because it is an adjournment motion, and the way our procedural and legal has advised me, you should have a right to speak on.
Can you clarify if this remains a link?
What has happened is we had to adjourn the motion, not deferred, not is to adjourn this hearing until certain documentation is brought back, and then to bring this hearing back in order as quickly as humanly possible. So I think what Dan has proposed, and I'm going to try to not put words into Dan's mouth, is he would like to put this meeting together on Tuesday, get together with MTO and the county and
the county the developers in the area.
And it's the pressure on MTO to get those culverts going as quickly as possible, as big as possible, satisfy all concerns, get back together again at this hearing, and get you going. That's what we're trying to do. We're not trying to keep a lot of time. I believe Dan's talking a quick timeline, quick turnaround.
We're trying to do an 8-week turnaround on this. We could do this within 8 weeks and get people on board with other developers that are going along with you as well. We can move this along a lot faster.
So the proposal that Deputy Mayor Davidson is proposing for Tuesday would be a meeting to need to explore some of the outstanding issues, bring to the table the MTO staff to understand some of the technical ramifications of their work. Address some of the outstanding issues that have been identified today, and then be able to bring back the results of that discussion to this board, resume the hearing, and then be able to give the board the advantage of the most current information, the most current thinking of all of the relevant parties around this development in the area, and then you would have, hopefully, a stronger basis to go forward and make a decision.
Sure.
It's to do with the timing.
One more time, I will repeat it. Be resolved, this hearing be adjourned to provide for the receipt of outstanding technical documentation for the proposed expansion of the Cookstown Outlet Mall proposal. In addition, to provide for the opportunity for discussion with the Town of Innisfil, County of Simcoe, and the Ministry of Transportation regarding potential floodplain matters affecting this area, and further that this matter be brought back to the board as soon